Hello everybody, Sportnight here, and welcome to a little recording of Super Smash Bros. Brawl. I wanted to play this for you today, or actually, I'm playing it for you on the day of the 20th anniversary of the Nintendo 64 being released. So, I wanted to play this for you today because of that, and I'm releasing it on Friday, and the anniversary was on June 23rd, which is the Thursday. That was the Japanese release, not the American release, which is where most of my subscribers are from. But, yeah, I thought that this would be awfully fun to play, and I'm just going to play a couple of matches. So, let's get to it. Let's see. Sector Z. I'm gonna play my three favorite maps.
3, 2, 1, go!
I actually tried to record this one other time, but I messed up with how the recording software works. So, now I understand how it works, and hopefully this episode actually works. There's so much nostalgia for me. The system came out before I was born, but I spent a lot of time playing on this system. So there's a lot of really good memories of playing on this. My first game system was the Game Boy Color. It was a little purple one. And I had Fire Red and Pokemon Yellow. Those were my two first video games I ever played. Boy, were they amazing. But for me, I got carried away on the spaceship. Anyways, that was the first game system I ever had. And then I got the next game system I had was either the DS or the Wii. I didn't get anything else in between there. And then after that, my cousin sold my family the N64 and all of his games. So there's a lot of time that I spent playing on it after that, and some of my favorite games are for it. Stop it. Stop it. No!
Show me the move!
Go for it, Pikachu. I'll let those two handle each other. There you go. One of the big reasons why I like Wii in the Wii version, and the Wii U version, 3DS version, all of those, I think the reason why I like the control layout is for here, the A button is the normal attack, and then the B button is the special attack. Ooh. No! No. Yeah, there we go. I didn't want that anymore. Walk into it, please.
Show me a move.
No. Yeah. works really great with the N64 controller, and it made all the other versions feel right at home to me. With playing with the sideways Wii remote controller, and then with the 3DS, I changed the layout for the controllers that the A button is the special, and then the B button is the and the B button is the normal attack. Yeah, bye. Gotta get rid of the box first. I remember, if you see where the little guns are, you can actually go and land on those and just survive down there if you're careful enough. Z and Saffron City are by far my favorite maps out of the 8 stages that they had. These two were awesome. And I'm gonna have to change my color again. There's a little Pokemon Center here, and Pokemon would appear up here, and then there's this helicopter pad here, which had nothing like super special. And then these little floaty pads in the building here. And that was all really nice, so yeah. Oh, Charmander. And get up there. Give me the bomb. In a song. Up attack. Go. Link was already defeated. Timer down here for, it's at 10 minutes or whatever. So, yeah. Good enough, I guess. Let's... No. Back. I want the blue Pikachu. And we're gonna play Hyrule Castle. This is for those of you who have never played the N64 version of Super Smash Bros., this is the first stage in, like, the Storm mode, or whatever you want to call it, that you will play, because you go up against Link. No, I almost had that! I hate him, but I hate him! I'm thinking of something right now. I'm thinking of some lyrics that would be funny, but... I don't think I will, because I'm trying to do, like, more of a kid-friendly show. Fox, go die. Well, I deserve that. Oh, I like how if you're up in the air, that little ball went here. Sure to leave a like down below and a comment. I'm gonna be doing more console gameplay sessions in the future. I know I want to record my PS4 and I'm going to record more of my N64. I just purchased this little doodad here that it lets me take the RCA, which is these three here, and convert it to an HDMI, which is what's letting me record this. And yeah, it's pretty cool, and, I'll do a recording setup video in the near future as well. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye!